It's good that the genre takes care of itself. You know, we've done a bunch of combinations coming from the hip-hop world and EDM and turntablism. And everything we feel should follow the lead that metal recognizes itself. Me and Be Real was just talking about that a second ago.
Yeah, I mean, you know, metal music has been important to a lot of us. I mean, you know, before I got into hip-hop, that's what I was listening to. And hip-hop is derived from a lot of different genres of music, including metal. So it's important that metal recognizes itself, just like the other musical genres. Can't depend on the Grammys and billboards and all that stuff to recognize a genre that has influenced many throughout the years. And the way that it keeps evolving, it's great. So, you know, hey, the spirit of metal still lives on.
People often talk about that phrase, the spirit of metal. Can you articulate for you what that is, what the essence of metal music is?
Balls out metal that's free. Like, you know, the artists that paved the way for this, they had a poetic freedom to how they presented the lyrics. It was very poetic style of writing back in that time, but with hard riffs, and you know, there were stories told in some of those songs. And then when it evolved into stuff that was you know, more today, you know, telling stories of what's going on today within their songs, I mean, it's great. It just keeps evolving and it keeps getting better. So, you know, I think that's the spirit, just rocking balls out and saying what you want to say. And you know, that's a big part of it.
What is the next chapter for you guys? What are you moving on to after tonight?
We're dropping an album September 15th called Prophets of Rage, self-titled. We got a new single out called Unfuck the World, and we're just going to keep, you know, on that goal to unfuck the world and rock the out while we're doing it.
Is the single quite a good indication for fans of what they can expect overall from that record?
Even more so. We're an organic group, so whatever comes to our mind, we'll record. But recording is only half the battle, as you guys know. Believing and bleeding it in performances, so that's what we do.
Yeah, you know, if people, you know, we put out an EP last year when we started this band. And, you know, if people like what we did on the EP, they're going to love what we did on this album, because we took it to another level. A level we knew we were well capable of, and we're excited. And, you know, waiting for it to come out so that the world can hear it.
Of course, the live shows as well are generating so much excitement at the moment. Can you tell us where we're going to see you next?
We'll be playing at Brixton Academy tomorrow night. After that, our tour schedule. I'm never really too for sure what city is next. But, you know, we're here in Europe for the next 3 weeks or so. Doing festivals and our own gigs, man. We're just trying to win people over as we go along, and you know, just have fun while we're doing it.
Is there a specific agenda for this new album in terms of what you're hoping it's going to achieve, both with fans and beyond that?
Yeah, and also that the world won't fix itself, and music can be a real spark plug in changing it. Would you agree, DJ Lloyd?
I agree.